The gates, they are a stripped. Nothing to them, except for what was on them to begin with. I'm going to leave my little gate latch, even though it's supped up. I got a couple new ones that came with the gate kit, the hinge kit. I was fortunate, it came with one of these. So I might, this is actually going to be on the wrong side, the way the hinges are set up. So I'll put that on the other gate probably, or maybe I'll just change the angle of these hinges, because I've set up to open up the other way. See how it's offset, opens up one way, but I can always twist those around. I lucked out, just saved me a little bit of labor. These old ones match my new ones, my new pins. So all I'm going to have to do really, loosen those up, get them in there, grease them up. And all I'll have to do is put the put this part on the gate, on the post. Don't have to screw around with the gates at all. Beauty. Coming along. I'm going to try to do this with one hand. These gate hinges go on quite simply. Let's see. Well, let's show it to you like this first. See the little slot there? There's a slot there too. They go into each other, rest in each other, and go around the pole. See? That's that. Now, take, oh, don't fall. Yeah. Take your gate pin, slide through, put your nut on, crunch crunch, great camera work, yeah, put your nut on there, ah. Finger tight, for now. There. Sorry about the crappy camera work. Should have done the tripod thing, but you'll want one pin facing down, one pin facing out or up. This way your gate can't be lifted off, and that's that. Okay, I think I said I was going to stop saying okay. Every time I start the camera, okay. So I'll stop saying that, okay? Alright. I got that gate on. Put that gate on. They're only just roughly on, but they're somewhat leveled and where they're going to be. Here's the gap I was telling you about. So this, let's see. My feet are a foot. So there's one. And two. Maybe 2.5 feet. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut this gate, or both gates. I'm going to measure halfway in between the curly Q and the end, so I get as much meat on either side as I can. That'll be roughly there. I'll cut, 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 cut. And what I have are some sleeves that are a little bit, but the inside diameter is a little bit bigger than the outside diameter. So what I'll do is when I have that cut, I'll cut sleeves, two of them, that split that in half. So I'll have one sleeve at about half for that side, and one sleeve at about half that length for that side, top and bottom. And I'm going to drill once I get it all set up, because what I'm going to do is do all this while the gate's on. And that way, when I've got the gate, when I got the sleeves on, I can actually slide both of them, you know, to and fro until I get it exactly where I want it. Then I can mark it for drilling, and it basically will become a custom fit. That's what's on the agenda, to elongate my gates. This is a pipe I'm going to use to elongate. It's a little rusty, but What the hell?
Nice day. No clouds.
Ooh. I should climb up the ladder and tap that down before the wind knocks it off. Got my gates marked off to cut. That's 6 inches from each side, top and bottom. You know, workmate there is to hold my shit together. Gates cut. Well, I'm gonna film one, just like the brake job. The other is exactly the same. So here's the open end. And this is what I'm gonna do with the sleeves. I'm gonna use this pipe. I had 28 and a half inches. So I'll need 14 on each side, plus maybe 3 inches beyond, maybe 4 inches beyond, so I got room to screw stuff in. And this is the other end of the gate. So what I'll basically be doing is making a sleeve. I can adjust it however I need to until it reaches where I want it, which is beauty. And then once I get it to where it is, I'll drill a hole there, going down, drill a hole here, going across, and I'll just put a bolt there and a bolt there on either side. And voila, my gates are elongated. Woo! Elongated. My gate extensions are cut. I cut them at 20 inches. That gives me 3 inches on either side of the actual elongation, plus a little bit of space for the hardware, so that's more than enough. My gates are all cut. That one's over there. There's my doggy. Hi, doggy. And all with the help of my Sawzall. Ooh, gotta love it. Sawzall grinder with your grinder attachments and metal cutting attachments. A must have. A must. Got that that extension ready. Now it's all loose right now, so I can't really show you exactly what it's going to do, but it's adjustable. I can move it in and out. Oops. Basically, I can slide it in and out. Oh, yeah. I can slide it back and forth until I get... That's close. Well, I think you get the idea. They slide in and out till I get it where I want it. And then I'll screw them down. And they won't be moving anymore.